हेलो माय डियर किड्स, वेलकम टू द क्लास ऑफ इंग्लिश सेकेंड मलबरी। सो वेलकम ऑल डियर माय स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 7। हेलो माय डियर चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू द क्लास ऑफ इंग्लिश सेकेंड मलबरी। सो हाउ आर यू? आई विश ऑल आर फाइन। सो माय डियर किड्स, दिस इज़ आवर बुक मलबरी कोर्स 7। इट मीन्स इट इज़ ऑफ 7th class, okay? This is the page of contents. So here content is given. First chapter is the 3 questions by Leo Tolstoy. Okay, so we will study first chapter. So this is a first chapter. Look here at the topic, the 3 questions, chapter number 1 and page number 17 in your book. So my dear kids, something is here at the top. Which of these is not a 3? Tick the correct answer. What is here? The first odd prime number, the angular points in a triangle, a hat trick in cricket, the number of strikes in baseball before a batter is out, the number of bears that lived in the house that Goldilocks visited, the number of mosquitoes in the title of Alexander Dumas' book. The only number whose name in English has the same number of letter as its value. So we have to tick the correct answer. So the answer, correct answer is 7th one. The only number whose name in English has the same number of letters as its value. Now the description of chapter. Activity is over. So here what we are going to study, just look. Let's read a story about a king who sought answer to 3 questions. Actually there is a king who is having a tension. We can't say that tension, actually something was bothering him. That was the thing, that 3 questions. He was having 3 questions to which he was searching the answer. So he asked to each and everyone, whosoever was wise or clever in his kingdom, but no one made him satisfied with the answer. So here we will read about that. Once upon a time there was a king who believed that he would be successful if he knew the answer to 3 questions. What was the right time to begin something? Who were the right people to listen to? And what was the most important thing to do? So here he was having 3 questions and he would be successful if he knew the answer to the 3 questions as the king believed. And what were the questions? Question number 1. What was the right time to begin something? It means what is the right time? When anyone can start the thing rightly. Second, who were the right people to listen to? Means if everyone is talking or wherever we were talking to everyone. But according to this, who is the most important person to listen? And what was the most important thing to do? So many actions we are having to perform. So many acts are there. But the question is, which is the most important thing to do? So these 3 questions are bothering him. So he tried to get the answer to these questions. So he announced that a great reward would be given to anyone who could satisfactorily answer these questions. Then he announced in his kingdom that whosoever can satisfy him with his answers for these 3 questions will be rewarded, and reward will be great. Great means big. Wise men came to the king, but they all gave different answers. So many persons came to him. Wise men came to him and gave the different answer. In reply to the first question, some said that to know the right time for every action, one must draw up in advance a table of days, months and years and must live strictly according to it. Others declare that it was impossible to decide beforehand the right time for every action. Means according to him, it is not an easy task to decide without it that what is the right time for every action. Hence, one should always do one's duty instead of wasting time in idleness. So, according to another person, that is that always we should perform our duty. We shouldn't waste our time on the idleness. Means we shouldn't sit lazily. We have to use or utilize our time. Others again said that the king should have a council of wise men who would help him fix the proper time for everything. Then others again said that the king should have a council. Council means a group of people chosen to give advice, of wise people who would help him fix the proper time for everything. It means they will be helpful to him to fix the time for the proper thing. In this way, he will be able to get the right answer to the question. Equally, various were the answers to the second question. Some said that the counselors were the most important people, others the priest, others the doctors, while some said the warriors were the most necessary. Then the answer to the second question was same as equally various were the answers. So many different answers he got for the second question too. Some said that the counselors means the committee of these clever people, wise people we can say, were the most important people. Others said that the priest, others the doctors, while some said the warriors were the most necessary, most important people. To the third question, what was the most important occupation? What was the most important action to perform? Some replied, the most important thing in the world was science. According to some, science is the most important thing. Others said it was skill in warfare, and others again that it was a religious worship. All the answers were so different that the king could agree with none of them and gave the reward to none. But when the king got the answers to these questions by these people, he was not satisfied. Which kind of answer he was demanding, that he didn't know. But actually he was not satisfied with the answer. So, he didn't give reward to anyone. But he still wished to find the right answer to his questions. But still, he was bothering with the questions. He was in a great, we can say he was very eager to know the answer to these questions. So, what he decided? He decided to consult a hermit widely renowned for his wisdom. So, he decided that now he will meet that hermit who was widely known person for his wisdom. He was very wise. The hermit lived in a forest which he never left, and he welcomed only common folk. About him, it was well known thing for each and everyone that hermit lived in a forest which he never left. And one thing else that is necessary to know, that is, he always welcome only common folk. Folk means common people. Not the king, not the high standard people, only common people could meet him. So before reaching the hermit's cottage, the king put on simple clothes, got off his horse, and leaving his bodyguard behind, went on alone. Then what the king did? He knew that he would not welcome to the king. So he decided to change himself, as he dressed himself as a common person when he was reaching to hermit's cottage. And what he did, he got off his horse and leaving his bodyguard behind him, he asked not to come with him and went on alone, and he reached there to be alone. The king went up to him and said, the hermit was digging the ground in front of his hut. When king entered in that area where hermit was living, he saw that the hermit was digging the ground in front of his hut. Seeing the king, he greeted him and went on digging. The hermit was frail. Each time he stuck his spade into the ground and turned a little earth, he breathed heavily. Seeing the king, he greeted him and went on digging. Means again he engaged with his work. The hermit was frail. Frail means weak. Each time he stuck his spade. Spade is a tool which we can use, which we use to dig the ground. So he was using that and he was digging with the help of that spade. When he was doing so, that he stuck his spade into the ground and turned a little earth. He breathed heavily. After doing so, he was feeling so tired. Actually, he was so much weak that he breathed heavily. Take a little bit rest. The king went up to him and said, I have come to you, wise hermit, with three questions. How can I learn to do the right things at the right time? Then the king went up to him and asked, What? I have come here to you, wise hermit, with three questions. I am having three questions and I need the answer to these three questions. How can I learn to do the right thing at the right time? Then first question he asked to him, that how can I learn? How can he be able to learn that what is the right thing to do at the right time? Second question, who are the people I need the most? Still I am unable to know that who is the most important people for me? Who is the most important person? So he is saying, who are the people I need the most? And what work is the most important and needs for my attention first? And he was asking that which is the most important work towards which he can pay the attention first. The hermit listened to the king but answered nothing and started digging again. While the king was asking the question, but hermit didn't respond that time. He was listening to him. He listened but he didn't answer and started digging again. You are tired, said the king. Let me take the spade and work a while for you. Then after this, what the king did? King asked to the hermit that you are tired. Then one thing you can do, I can do the work. You can give your spade to me and I can dig the ground for you. Let me take the spade and work a while for you. It means I can do this work for you. You can have a rest. Thank you, said the hermit, and giving the spade to the king, he sat down on the ground. To listen to that, what the hermit did? He gave the spade to the king and sitting aside, sat down on the ground aside. One hour passed and then another. The sun began to sink behind the trees and the king at last stuck the spade into the ground and said, I came to you, wise man, for an answer to my question. If you can give me none, tell me so and I will return home. Then 1 hour passed and then another, but still the king didn't get anything, means any answer. Sun began to sink. It is begin to set behind the trees. Then what's happened there? The king at last stuck the spade into the ground. It means to say he left that spade there to stuck into the ground and said to whom? To king. I came to you, wise man, for an answer to my questions. If you can give me none, means if you are unable to give the answer to my question, so tell me directly. So and I will return home so that I can be back to my home. Because still he was unable to get the answer. That's why we can say a little bit frustration he was having or anything else. And while he was helping to the king also, but to the hermit, but still he didn't get the answer to the question. Means hermit was simply quiet to listen to that. That's why he was asking, if you don't know the answer, then tell me so that I can be back to my home. then hence sorry here comes someone running, said the hermit, let us see who it is. Then when they were talking to each other and king was asking that if you don't know the answer to my question then tell me, I will be back to my home. In between someone was coming towards them running, said the hermit, let us see who it is. The king turned around and saw a man coming running out of the forest. There was blood flowing from a wound on his leg. Then suddenly what happened? When the king turned, he saw a man come running out of the forest. And there was blood flowing from a wound on his leg. Actually, he was having a wound on his leg. From that, the blood is coming. Bleeding is too much. When he reached the king, he fell to the ground, mourning feebly. When that person who was coming to them, running from the forest, he was so much in trouble and the wound was so much, we can say, troublesome for him, that he fell to the ground, mourning feebly. We can say that he was having a lot of pain. The king washed the wound as best he could and bandaged it with his handkerchief and with the towel the hermit had. Then what the king did? King washed his wound as best as he could and bandaged it with his handkerchief, means hanky, that was that the king was having, and with the towel that the hermit was having. When at last the man felt better, the king brought fresh water and gave it to him. When at last the man was feeling better after bandage, then king brought some fresh water for him and gave to him. Meanwhile, the sun had set and it had become cool. Then what's happened? In between, the sun had set completely and the weather was very cool there, so the king with the hermit's help carried the wounded man into the hut and laid him on the bed. Then to look at that situation, what the king did, he took the help of hermit and lifted the wounded person, and they took them into the hut and made him rest on bed. Laid him on the bed. Lying on the bed, the man closed his eyes and was quiet. The king was so tired from his walk and the work he had done that he crouched down on the threshold. Then what's happened with the king? He was too much tired after digging the ground that he was feeling asleep, and he sat down at the threshold of the hut. Threshold means the gate. And fell asleep. When he awoke in the morning, he found that the wounded stranger was staring intently at him. When next morning, when king woke up, he saw that the strange person was sitting in front of him and staring at him intently. Means as he was feeling ashamed on him. So forgive me, said the man in a weak voice. Then what's happened? The man started. Which man? Wounded man. Asked to him to forgive him. The voice was very weak. When he saw that the king was awake and was looking at him. I don't know you and have nothing for to forgive you, said the king. Then king was surprised. What is going to be done in front of him? Then he asked, I don't know, who are you? And I have nothing to forgive you. So why are you asking me forgiving? You do not know me, but I know you. I am an enemy of yours who swore to revenge himself on you. Then he started to give his introduction, who he was. He told, you do not know me, the king, but I know you. I am an enemy of yours who swore to revenge himself on you, who decided definitely one day he would take revenge from you. as you wrongly took away my property. I knew you had gone alone to see the hermit and planned to ambush you on your way back. Then I came to know that you are going alone to the hermit's cottage, so I decided that now on the way I will take the revenge. So I planned to ambush you on your way back. It means to take revenge. But you did not return, so I came out to find you. Then that enemy was saying that I was waiting for you, but you didn't return. Then I came to you and decided that definitely I will try to find to you. Your bodyguard recognized him, but on the way when he was coming to the king, that time what's happened with him? That king's bodyguard recognized him. Bodyguard. As I ran away, I fell and I was wounded. Then he was saying when he was running from them, that time he fell down and was wounded. So I should have bled to death if you had not nursed me. Then he was saying that if the king had not nursed him, so definitely he'd die because of flow of the blood. I wish to harm you and you have saved my life. Now if I live and if you wish it, I will serve you most faithfully. Forgive me. This time he was feeling regret. That's why he was saying that now it is my wish as you saved my life while I was thinking to take your life, but you saved my life. So I request you or I wish to serve you most faithfully. Forgive me. The king was happy to make peace with his enemy. He was very happy. He not only forgave him, but said he would send his own physician to retreat him and promise to restore his property. Then the king went out and looked around for hermit. He wished once more to beg an answer to his question before leaving. Then when the king was about to leave from that cottage, he thought that once again I will go to hermit and last time I will ask to the answers to my question. The hermit was outside sowing seeds in the beds that had been dug the day before. Then what the hermit was doing, he was sowing the seeds in that area which was dug last day, matlab means before day. The king approached him and said, for the last time I pray you to answer my question, wise man. You have already been answered, said the hermit. Then what the king told him, approached him and said, for the last time, this is the last time, wise man, I am asking the answer to my question. I pray you to answer my question, wise man. Then what he told, you have already been answered, said the hermit. Then king was shocked to listen to that. Still he didn't tell any answer to me. How could I get? Really it was shocking for me. I mean to say for the king. How answered? What do you mean by? Asked the king. The king asked, how answered? What do you mean? Do you not see, replied the hermit, if you had not pitied my weakness yesterday and had not stayed back to dig those bats for me, so you would have been attacked by that man on your way back. Then he explained all the situation and answer to his question that if you had not pitied my weakness yesterday, he was saying that if you didn't show the pitiness on my weakness yesterday when I was digging, I was feeling tired. That time you showed the pity, na? If you didn't show, then what's happened? You didn't dig the bats for me. And if you would have been attacked by that man on your way back, then definitely you would die. So the most important time was when you were digging the bats, because that time saved your life. It means that was the most important time for you, when you were saved. And that I was the most important person, and to do me good was your most important business. And that time when you observed me that I was feeling tired, I was unable to dig the ground properly, so you helped me. You understood that I need that help. And afterwards when the man ran to us. The most important time was when you were attending to him. Now when that man who was wounded, fully bleeding was there, he was unconscious, you helped him. The most important time was when you were attending to him. If you had not bound up his wounds, he would have died without having made peace with you. So he was the most important person who need your attention at first that time. And what you did for him was your most important work. That time you didn't know who was he. Only thing you knew that this is the time to help him, to save his life, that you did, and that was the most important thing to do. Remember, then three, there is only one time that is right now. Now he told him, this is the right time for you, that is now. It is the most important time because it is the only time when we have any power. The most important person is the one with whom you are at a particular moment. No one knows whether you will ever meet anyone else in future. The most important thing to do is to do good, because for that purpose alone are we sent into this life. So, who is the most important person, and who is, what is the most important time for you, and what is the most important thing to you, that I hope you understood. So my dear kids, I hope you enjoyed the chapter. Now you understood who is the most important person for you. Now you understand the right person, right time and right situation. It means to say right work to do. I hope the chapter is clear to you. So my dear kids, revise the chapter and stay at home, stay safe, keep in touch of your study. Thank you. Thank you, my dear kids.